Oh, thank you. Wow. There's just something so poignant about being on the stage.
And I realized that my work in defining my ideal client and really taking that seriously and making sure that it gets translated into my marketing ensures that I love what I do and that I only work the amount that I want. Can you guys make that connection? Can you imagine that if you really put out the SOS, the beacon, the frequency that only your ideal clients could hear, and then they came, and you got to serve at the level that you wanted to, that you wouldn't need to work so much? Is that anybody feeling that? But how many of you feel like the tools that you have to talk about what you do, they're not doing it 100% of the way that they should be, right? They're not doing their job. They really could be doing a good job for you. And that's what I was experiencing. And so how many of you feel like you're actually being held back from going out there in a bigger way because you don't have those things that really express who you are in a big way? Okay. And I do this hand-raising thing for a really significant purpose. So whenever you find yourself raising your hand, like, make a note. Because all these questions that you're saying yes to, I want you to remember. Because when you have a book full of notes about your signature talk, which is why you're here, and then you go, okay, I need to get out there and talk to promoters about why they want to have me versus the 10 other people that appear to be doing what I'm doing, I want you to go back to your juicy marketing notes. Agreed? Deal? Okay. As Bella, we say, Bella, you want to shake on it? And she says, yeah. So I want you standing all up, and I want you all to shake on it. All right, let's shake on it. All right, thank you. But remember what you're shaking on. You're shaking on that you're making a mental note that when you start struggling with how to put yourself out there when you have your talk and how to attract the gigs and how to attract the people, that you're going to go back to this section of your work. We're not going to talk about what you're doing today. We're not going to talk about all that stuff, because here is one of my favorite quotes from a very famous juicy marketer, Lisa Cherney. It's not about what you're doing or not doing in your marketing. It's not about all that stuff. It is about what you're saying or not saying. So let's say this all together. It's not about what you're doing or not doing. It's what you're saying or not saying. So when your head is spinning all around with all those things that the gurus and everyone tells you that you have to be on the web, oh my God, you're on the web, or you have to be on social media and all of this, I'll take a deep breath. And know that you need to figure out what you're going to say there first, because you're going to be wasting a lot of time and a lot of energy. How many of you feel like your work is your mission? Like you have work to do. It is your. This is why you're here on the planet. So of course it's going to evolve as you evolve, right? And so does your marketing need to evolve. So I'm going to give you some tools that you can use right away to make sure that it is always update and current so that you attract what you want. Does that sound good? Okay, great. One of the reasons why I came to creating ideal clients is because of that whole realizing that I traded one awful boss for another about a year into my business. And I realized that about 20% of the people that I was attracting that I really loved working with. And that left a lot of people that were a pain in the butt. And I realized I'm using target market and niche and all these things I had known. I mean, I worked for top advertising agencies both in Minneapolis and LA, and I'm like at a loss. So I had to give myself a huge marketing lobotomy. It was not pretty, you guys. When I think of ideal client, it's a pyramid. The bottom part is your target, the widest part. If you have a niche, which you don't need one. I know the marketing police is gonna come in that door any minute, but I'm telling you, you don't need a niche, because if you go right to the tippy top part of the pyramid, and you just go for that ideal client and you do the work to get clear there, the niche just falls out. If you force it, if you force a niche, which I know many of you have been forced or forced yourself, because everyone tells me I'm gonna get rich if I have a niche, but you're not feeling it yet, it's empty. So go right, just, I am giving you permission. All right, stand up, we gotta do a little pledge. Stand up, all right. No, not really a pledge. Let's see what it's gonna be like, an anointment. I, Lisa Cherney, the juicy marketing expert, from here on, June 9th, 2011, give you permission to only work with your ideal clients. If you accept, say, I do.
I do.
All right, awesome. Now, there is this marketing medical diagnosis that I am the only one in the world. I shouldn't say that. I'm training coaches right now. So me and a couple other people in the world are certified in diagnosing this condition. And I'm just going to tell you right now, prepare yourself, because it's likely that you have it. Okay, so like hold on to your seat. You ready? Okay. It's called Multiple Ideal Client Personality Disorder. Raise your hand before I even describe it. Okay. So the people that are mostly afflicted are those where they believe in what they do. Their work is their mission. Because you want to help everybody. And everybody needs what you have to offer. And honestly, they do, right? I mean, right? Doesn't nearly everybody need what you have to offer? They can all benefit from what you have to offer, right? But if you market to everybody, you market to no one. And so most people that come to me have multiple ideal client personality disorder. And as a result, they're going over here to talk to parents, and then they're going over here to talk to engineers, and then they're going over here to talk to people with messy desks, and then they're going over here to talk to people that want natural healing, and then they're going crazy.